Coming back to the issue of nuclear renaissance, which has been talked about, it is already collapsing because of the economics of nuclear power. That's a separate issue. But do you think that this accident will really make people rethink on two issues? One is extension of the life of those nuclear reactors, which are already 40 years old. And the other is, of course, that what happens in future nuclear plants?
I think there are, in the last decade, there have been three trends. One, the extension of life for reactors, which original designers and regulators had really written off after a certain number of years, but now you're extending it. The second thing is to going in for much larger and larger capacity reactors, like the EPR, which is 1650 megawatt. The third one is placing more than four or five reactors in one site. Now, the root cause behind all these three is economics, because you want larger reactors because one feels that there is a cost effectiveness and economy of size coming into play. Six in a site because a lot of common work has to be done, which then will serve all the six reactors. Six of them being placed. I think everything, the economics has driven these things, really not engineering and safety thinking. That's what I'm saying. So therefore, all these aspects are going to be rethought of, and one may go back to the earlier thinking of conservatism in all these three areas. And as you know, world over, every country is re-examining their nuclear policies. There are very few like India who are foolishly saying that everything is safe and we are all right. But that's a very wrong notion. We should also pause and look at it.
In fact, Tarapur has both the problems. It's more than 40 years old. It's also even an older Mark I design. So do you think we should relook at Tarapur's...
Tarapur has also existing problems. The two steam generators are completely conked out. The reactor originally was designed for 200 megawatt, and it operated at 200 megawatt for some time, and then because we did not maintain water chemistry properly in both those reactors, the steam generators, completely the tubes gave way, and a lot of resulting radioactivity release, etc., took place in those days. So there was a period when Tarapur needed a whole lot of cleanup for this. All this came about also because of the early vintage designs. It was the first or second or third General Electric reactor built anywhere in the world. And at that time, the tube material chosen was chosen without really understanding the water chemistry maintenance in India or the other way. We really did not get too much guidance in this, and the General Electric themselves did not know much. So it was part of their learning experience that these two steam generators had to be sacrificed. And they were in such a location in terms of a physical location that, and the knowledge and availability of robotic equipment was very poor. We are talking about 30, 40 years ago. And that we could not really cut and remove them and replace them with other steam generators. The only thing was to wall them off and abandon them. And that's what we have done. Now we have these two steam generators through which water is not passing at all. And because of that, we lost certain extra steam which would have been generated is lost, and therefore the reactors had been derated to 160. Then, as I said, later on came the problem of this suppression pool dynamics, which was causing a lot of problem in America. Even in the US, the USAEC came very close to really instructing to shut down the boiling water reactors of the Mark I type. But again, arguments were used that it will be too much of a financial loss, and they were allowed to continue. So we also have continued without really making much changes. So in the other thing is this being one of the early reactors, and with the 1974, our Pokhran 1 and all that, General Electric has not left behind many of the drawings. So as built reactor, we practically have no drawings at all. So tomorrow there is a serious problem and there's an emergency and somebody has to do some work internally. Frankly, the as built reactor is not there. When we did some inspection, we were surprised to see certain welded joints and all that, which are not there in the original drawings at all. So where all what modifications they have done during construction time, they have not dutifully brought them into a drawing and handed it over to the Indians. So we are sitting here with a reactor whose even where the welding has been done, whether it has been heat relieved or not, all these questions are there, a large number of questions are there. And we are only getting 320 megawatt out of these two reactors. So it's about time that India very seriously should take a look to see whether we want to have this potential additional problem from these two reactors just for the sake of retaining 320 megawatts.
So if we really come right down to it, this is going to be a dampener on the nuclear scenario, and definitely most countries would re-examine the nuclear issues. Though it must also be said, the fact that in spite of all this, there has been no large-scale release of radiation must also be set to the, at least to the credit of the nuclear engineers.
Yeah, that's true. I think that there was a containment has breached. The reason large-scale release did not take place, one is because the reactors shut down dutifully on earthquake, which it's expected to do, and it did. I mean, mentally, we always try to compare with Chernobyl. And, you know, we don't realize that Chernobyl is something which was very, I mean, came out of utter stupidity in a way.
Because completely a man-made
reactor was already operating and people were fooling around with doing testing and all that. It should really be compared with Three Mile Island to some extent. In which case, you know, is it worse than Three Mile Island? I would say it is. It is worse because there are four reactors involved and they're all releasing it. And so a better comparison point is that. Yes, nevertheless, I think you should say it is to the credit that it has really. And that's why I think one will not, I hope this incident will not lead to a any wide decision to stop nuclear power per se. But I think the growth from here on will be a safe and slow approach, and will be, if it kills nuclear power or slows down nuclear power, it will be because of the economics of it. Because now the kind of shortcuts we did about keeping a reactor for much longer than its lifetime as seen by engineers and material scientists, in the name of economics, I think this probably will not be any more possible.
And one should relook at the size issue that you have raised as well.
And actually already, if you recall the RUSI report from EDF, they have taken a close look at EPR again at the instruction of the French government. And one of the conclusions they came to is that perhaps in the next round, a lower rating EPR should be attempted. The large rating has made it more complex, and perhaps to avoid the complexity, one should go back to a lower rating.